wind and solar have both plunged in cost so deeply, so unexpectedly quickly, that those are now the cheapest, cleanest sources of power by every measure. You know, when it comes to just what's the cheapest way to put an electron of power on the grid, wind and solar win hands down, at least if you're in terms of anything new that you're building. If you come to building anything from scratch, those are your cheapest power sources. So as much as we can lean on those cheapest, cleanest sources, we want that to be a big part of the mix.
The cheapest energy projects anywhere in the world last year and the year before and the year before were all solar or wind projects. And no amount of arguing around subsidies and things can detract from the fact that clean energy is now the cheapest or at the low end of the cost rung. So that is the number one transformation on the landscape. And not only does that mean that you can now look at the overnight cost of projects being cheapest for renewables, but it also means they've scaled. And so if you want to do anything from an individual home to a community to a gigawatt scale utility project, renewables are probably the cheapest basically anywhere you are.
We, just like every other analytical firm, have been wrong and always in the same direction. Everybody in the world has consistently for the last 10 years underpredicted the price declines in solar in particular, but also wind. And now we're seeing that happen with lithium ion storage as well.
It's unclear that the cost of that nuclear electricity will be able to compete with just where solar and wind is going. That's the reality.